sick of falling to death trying to make those perilous long jumps? Are you riding a Yoshi? Then worry no more, my young friend. Just try the patented Yoshi Sacrifice. Merely press the jump button to send your cute friend who saved you from being eaten by Koopas when you were a baby hurling into the abyss while you make it safely to your destination. That's Dr. Horrigan's wonderful Yoshi Sacrifice. Available now at your favorite dime and nickel store.
Dear Nintendo, hi, it's me, Austin, and today what I have on my Ruin Your Childhood agenda is Mario Jumpman Mario Amphibian Murderer Extraordinaire, and I'm going to be focusing on something really specific, the Yoshi Sacrifice. This is a move that originates all the way back in, God, this is going to make me feel so old, 1990, nearly 30 years with the introduction of Yoshi to the Nintendo franchise in Super Mario World. Since then, it's more or less become a trope so long-lived that it's appeared in almost every game you could ride Yoshi in if you want, is a recurring staple in the Dorkly Bits shorts, has several Super Mario Maker levels dedicated to using this mechanic, and even has its own song. And it's been my utter and complete obsession for the past few weeks, and I have been focusing my laser-visioned science brain on this problem because it is deceptively complicated. It's a great example of the fun things you can do with basic Newtonian physics, and since this problem has been keeping me up at night, losing sleep, writing on the walls like a mad person in the middle of the night when there's plenty of paper lying around everywhere, this is the madness I'm going to subject you to. Join me in the abyss of newtons, kilograms, meters, and seconds per second. Okay, so the basics. All right, let's review. This is a Newtonian physics problem. No pressures, no relativity, just basic masses, accelerations, and speeds, which means we have three principal rules to keep in mind. The three laws of motion as laid out in Sir Isaac Newton's treatise, Philosophia Naturalis Principia Mathematica. And they are as such. Corpus omne preserare. Stop it! You literally did the exact same joke less than a year ago in the Super Smash Brothers episode. Bad Austin! All right, okay, you're right. Okay, real quickly, the three laws of motion are an object either remains at rest or continues to move at a constant velocity unless acted upon by an outside force. The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the force applied, and this change in momentum takes place in the direction of the applied force, and when one thing applies a force on something else, the something else exerts a force back on the first thing. These three ideas are all we need to figure out if this Yoshi sacrifice jump is possible. And that's right, I did say possible, because the first hurdle I thought of was, well, this is a closed system. Is it even possible for Mario to jump and change his velocity if he's part of a closed system in the air? And in order to answer this question, we need to do a thought experiment. Imagine instead that Yoshi and Mario were floating in orbit. Okay, no, wait, okay, they have spacesuits on, and okay, all right, that's better. Anyway, if Mario pushed against Yoshi, would he be able to float away? And the answer is yes, he would. The important thing is that not only would Mario float away, he'd also send Yoshi floating off, because in order to move himself, he'd have to create an equal and opposite force. So Yoshi would go floating in the other direction. You can even test this for yourself if you want. Just grab something from your table or whatever and jump in the air, and while you're in the air, throw the thing that you grabbed up into the air. I chose a pen when I did it, and there's two things worth noting. One, it is surprisingly difficult to time your throw correctly, and two, the pen, while it might not seem like it, is actually making me fall to the ground faster than I would have if I hadn't thrown it, since it is exerting a downward force on my body in order to send itself up. This will become very important later on. Okay, so the jump is possible. End of episode, I guess. Wait, no, because this maneuver is way more complicated than two objects floating in space or me making an idiot of myself in my apartment. There's lots of factors here, so let's start at the most simple step first, the physics of Mario's jump, and then we'll build up from there. Okay, so here's the Earth, and here's Mario. And since Super Mario World is the first game that has the Yoshi sacrifice mechanic, this is the game, whenever possible, that we're gonna be doing all our measurements in. So, first things first, we gotta jump. Good job, buddy! Using Mario's cannon height, 1.55 meters, we can figure out exactly how high he's jumping each time in this game. 3.69 meters. It takes him 0.5166 seconds to reach peak height, and it takes him 0.45 seconds to accelerate downward and hit the ground. With all that information, we can figure out the surface gravity of the game, which is 36.419 meters per second squared, almost four times Earth's gravity. Now, the pedants among you are going to point out that Mario does reach a terminal velocity where he doesn't accelerate anymore, and that all the acceleration downward is happening in the first few seconds as he's falling, to which I say, if we go by that metric, the surface gravity of our world would be over 240 meters per second squared, or over 23 times the surface gravity of Earth. That is over 10 times the surface gravity of Jupiter, so 36.4 it is. But here's where the fun part starts, because knowing all of this, we can figure out Mario's initial velocity when he leaves the ground, which is important because after his feet leave the ground, Mario can no longer impart any real energy into his body, and his velocity is locked in, and the only thing acting on him, aside from negligible air resistance, is the downward pull of gravity. Thankfully, all we have to do is take this formula that equates potential and kinetic energy and rearrange it so that our unknown velocity is on one side. Mass cancels out, and we get the square root of 2 times gravity, which we have, times height, which we also have, all of which gives us a result of 16.38 meters per second, or 36 miles per hour. That is quite the jump. But we are still not done, because all this work only gets us one piece of a three-part puzzle. We need to figure out what we really want, for reasons that will become clear later, which is the force Mario is exerting on the ground. And for that, we're gonna need force equals mass times acceleration. You see, when you're standing on the ground, you're actually exerting a force on the ground. Let's simplify this. A 1 kilogram mushroom sitting on the ground in the Mushroom Kingdom is exerting a force on that ground, which is mass times acceleration due to gravity. 1 times 36.4 is 36.4. Newtons. The ground is, in turn, per Newton's third law, exerting an equal and opposite force on the mushroom, creating a net force of zero, letting the mushroom stay still. In order for it to jump, well, it would have to grow legs, but let's just imagine it can jump without them. It's gonna have to exert a force on the ground that's greater than the pull of gravity. If it exerts just 38.4 newtons, the ground will push back with a force of 38.4 newtons, giving the mushroom a net upward force of 2 newtons once you subtract gravity, which is enough to cancel out the pull of gravity and accelerate the mushroom up a whopping 1 meter per second per second. Not super impressive. But acceleration, force, these things need time in order to really mean anything to us. And in fact, force equals ma can be written longhand as force equals mass times change of velocity over time. In order to get any meaningful data from Mario's jump and the amount of forces exerted on his body, we need to know how much time it takes him to jump. We need to know this for a few reasons. If we look back at that mushroom, if you plop it into a vacuum and push on it with 2 newtons for 1 second, it'll accelerate to 2 meters per second. But if you apply that force continuously, forever, it'll reach near light speeds in less than 150 million years.
Hi there, everyone. Future Austin here from my desk while I'm editing this video. I realized I made a mistake that I've actually made in the past before, and instead of just patching it out, I actually thought I would explain what happened really quickly before somebody says anything. I mixed up my units because I just divided the speed of light by 2 for the acceleration, and the problem is that gives you 149 million seconds because the acceleration is in meters per second. The reason I thought it'd be interesting to talk about this is because a lot of people mess up their units when they're starting to do this kind of math, and I wanted to show the errors that those can cause and how really easy it is to do. So if you actually divide by the number of seconds that are in a year, which is 31,540 seconds, you get 4.75 years, which is a huge difference from 149 million years. Anyway, I wanted to correct that. On with the episode! Million years! In short, in order to know how much force Mario is exerting in his jumps, we need to know how long it takes him to reach the
speed of 16.38 meters per second. And while games have frame-perfect reaction times and he jumps instantly, this would create incredibly high forces. A more realistic model, determined experimentally by athletic scientists, suggests that vertical leaps impart force into the ground over the course of about 0.5 seconds, which means Mario's going from 0 meters per second to 16.38 in just 0.5 seconds, which gives us, finally, an acceleration of 32.77 meters per second per second. Now we just need Mario's mass, which I figured out to be 89 kilograms already a while ago using literal rocket science, which gives Mario's jump force a whopping value of 2,917 newtons. Math! Now that you know the basics, let's get back to Yoshi, because this is where things get really interesting. We actually have to calculate two separate values, because Mario can jump off of Yoshi at two different points. He can jump off at peak jump height, which is the most feasible, but more terrifyingly, he can jump just as high while falling at terminal velocity. And even more terrifying, I found out that the height difference, that is the difference from his feet at the start of the jump to the top of the jump, is actually higher if he's jumping off Yoshi. For whatever reason, Mario can jump over 5.5 meters if he jumps off of Yoshi's back. OMG. This gives us an initial velocity of 20.5 meters per second we have to reach in just 0.5 seconds. Now, at the height of Yoshi's jump, this means he's exerting 3,650 newtons into poor Yoshi's back. And here is where things get out of control. Because remember, objects exerting forces on other objects create an equal and opposite force. The pen in my hand is pushing me down, remember, and making me fall faster. Imagine a nearly 200-pound plumber is jumping off my back in midair. That is going to send me flying. And in this case, me is Yoshi. Yoshi would go flying downward, but by how much? Well, that depends upon Yoshi's mass. Is Yoshi the pen, or is Mario the pen? And finding the answer to this was not easy. Mario Kart puts Mario and Yoshi in the same weight class, so they're probably pretty similar, but that's not a lot to go by. Finally, I figured it out. If we can find an object that exerts uniform forces on both of them, we can determine how much more one weighs than the other, if at all, based on how much they move. Yes, that object exists, and it's the springboard. Unfortunately, the springboard in Super Mario World does not affect Yoshi if he's off your back, but it does affect Yoshi independently in Super Mario Maker. Mario Maker isn't the exact same size as Mario World, but the physics are nearly perfectly scaled pixel by pixel with about 5% margin of error. Not perfect, but it's what I got. And guess what? They do hop up at different heights when left alone. Yoshi travels approximately 16% higher, meaning he weighs 16% less than Mario, which means he's about 74.6 kilograms, which is bad news for this little guy because he's already going to start accelerating downwards at 36.4 meters per second per second due to gravity, plus an extra 48 meters per second from the 3,640 newtons Mario's putting into him, meaning he's going to be hitting the ground at an earth-shattering 42.6 meters per second, or over 95 miles per hour. That is like a car crash, but it gets even worse because Mario can pull this same move off while traveling downward at terminal velocity, 30.75 meters per second, which means in order to jump up 5.775 meters, he has to impart enough force to cancel out all 89 kilograms of the plumber traveling downward, and then enough to accelerate him up still. If we take Mario's initial velocity of 20.5 and subtract the negative velocity, 30.75, his velocity downward, we learn that his initial speed leaving Yoshi has to be 51 meters per second, or over 100 miles per hour, which would require an acceleration of over 102 meters per second per second, which would require 9,121 newtons of force, which would accelerate Yoshi 122 meters per second per second in the opposite direction, leading to a top net speed of over 91 meters per second, which is, get this, over 205 miles per hour. That is like accelerating a McLaren F1 to almost top speed and then driving it straight into a concrete wall. And that's completely neglecting the pressures exerted on the bones of Yoshi's back that would likely completely powderize his spine from the jump alone if the fall didn't kill him. And also, if Mario is capable of exerting 9,124 newtons of force, that'd mean his top
jump height from the ground should be over 36 meters or 118 feet. Why aren't you jumping like this all the time? So yeah, it turns out that yes, this move is theoretically possible. It's just, no matter what, terrible for Yoshi. Mario is such a jerk. I mean, whether it's being mean to his brother, sending his pets off to die in bottomless pits, or sending them slamming into the ground faster than a speeding bullet so that they turn into dinosaur pulp, Mario consistently is the most evil character Nintendo has ever made. And that's the kind of fun things you can do with classical physics. Sincerely, Austin.